Hi there, Deanna Seitz here. Did you know that percussionists play Bach's solo violin sonatas and partitas for their orchestra auditions? Well, here's my third Bach with a Seitz twist, in which I collaborated with my wonderful friend and a fantastic marimba player, Xueqing. Enjoy. Thank you so much, Shui, for the beautiful playing. I had so much fun playing Bach with Shui, bassoonist Gilda Jean, and harpist Jessica Wilby as we were working on these video series. By the way, if you haven't done so, make sure to check out the first two Bach with a Seitz twist videos. As we were working on this fun experiment, I asked my colleagues about the importance of Bach's music in their musical studies and careers. And here are their answers.
Bach is one of my favorite composers. When I was younger, I played the flute, and one of my favorite pieces to play was the solo Partita that he wrote for flute. And when I was a student, I also would play every Sunday afternoon for about 2 years. We played at a restaurant for brunch, and we had a flute, a clarinet, and bassoon trio, and we would play the trio sonatas of Bach. And I also transcribed some of the organ trio sonatas for Bach. Bach is a great composer because he really knows how to write for any instrument. I mean, it really doesn't matter what instrument it is. I mean, he was an organist, but his lines are so well thought out that they sound great on any instrument. And harmonically, he can be very adventuresome even for the period that he was writing it.
Great. Well, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed our little experiment.
Yes, it was very nice.
I really had fun.
Very nice to do something very different like this. I'm used to playing the cello suites, not the violin and partitas.
Yeah, Gil did a lot of work to actually transcribe it for the bassoon and phrasing. It was very fun because the phrasing went a little different, but it did work, right? It was quite, you were able to make it quite organic for the bassoon, which is, I think, is amazing. That's how Bach writes, right?
Right. Bach sounds great on any instrument.
Thank you so much again.
Okay. I always tell my students that these sonatas and partitas are basically the Bible, violinist Bible. So, but I found out that you say that you harpists play it too, right?
Yes, we have a whole book of them. They were transcribed for harp by a harpist named Marcel Grajany. We kind of refer to him as like the master of transcriptions for harp, because he transcribed a lot of things that were written for organ and violin and lots of music, and transcribed them for harp. And he took all of the partitas and all the pieces by Bach and arranged them for harp. So we learn them as part of our studies, they teach harpists all about how to work through a line smoothly, and the fingering and the technique, as well as distinguishing between harmony and melody. Because we play with, you know, eight fingers, we have a lot of different notes going on, and we have to make sure that you can always hear the melody through all the harmony.
Amazing. And do you guys have your own repertoire by Bach that you play?
No, Bach didn't write anything for harp. Harp was not a popular instrument when he was composing, and so that's why Grosjeny took it upon himself to transcribe pretty much, not everything, but quite a bit.
Wow. So it's pretty important, right? So he thought that Bach was so important that he even transcribed it to make sure you guys had something by Bach to play.
Oh, definitely.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I really enjoyed it.
Well, this is it for today. I really enjoyed creating these Bach videos for you. I don't think there's any music written for solo violin that could ever come close to Bach's sonatas and partitas. We are so fortunate to have this volume written especially for our instrument. So wherever you are in your musical studies or career, make sure to play Bach as much as possible and as often as you can. And if the idea of performing on stage all by yourself is a little scary to you, just find a friend and play Bach with a Seitz twist. It also makes a great hack for memorizing the doubles in this partita. Once you hear a dance movement along with its double, suddenly the double will make much more sense to you, both melodically and harmonically. In fact, this is how I stumbled upon this little discovery of mine. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share it. And let me know in the comments section what you think of my crazy experiment. I'm looking forward to the next week when I will be sharing with you one of my arrangements recorded during my summer travels. So if you haven't done so, make sure to subscribe and hit the little bell icon to get notified about my new posts. Until then, have a wonderful week and happy hacking.